Hi, everyone. My name is Earl Duque, Senior Developer Advocate at ServiceNow, and thank you for joining me in this series of videos called Let's Learn ECMAScript 2021. But first, what does ECMAScript 2021 even mean? Okay, so if you're like me, you learned almost all of your JavaScript in the context of ServiceNow or any other software that came along between 2009 and 2015. Okay, so ECMAScript is a standard upon which JavaScript is based on so that apps, websites, etc. can be compatible with each other and with other stuff. The scripting engine we have used in ServiceNow for the longest while is based on ECMAScript 5. And it's been locked to ES5 for a really long time. And then in 2015, ES6 came along and added a bunch of features to JavaScript, but ServiceNow was locked into ES5. New versions of ECMAScript have come out yearly since then, all the way up to ECMAScript 12, or what we're calling it, ECMAScript 2021, which is when it came out in 2021. So for the longest time, ServiceNow developers did not have access to all the fun stuff that came out in ES6. Basically anything that came out after ES5, things that made JavaScript easier, more robust, and more efficient. For example, have you ever Googled a JavaScript question and the first response was a Stack Overflow result with a top answer that referenced the arrow, the equals, and then the greater sign, but it didn't work when you copy and pasted it into ServiceNow? That's why. Arrow functions weren't introduced until ES6, and because we were in ES5, we couldn't use arrow functions. But as of the Tokyo release of ServiceNow in late 2022, we gained access to many of the features in ES2021, specifically in our scoped applications. Which brings us to this video. I was a developer that learned on ES5 JavaScript, and I want to bring you up to speed on all the cool new stuff that you can do now that we can use ECMAScript 2021. So in each lesson, we will explore a new concept or functionality. A couple of things before we get started, though. I'm going to assume you already know JavaScript and you generally know ServiceNow. If you don't, my colleague Chuck Tomasi and myself, we have a solid playlist for you called Learn JavaScript on the ServiceNow platform. Just look for that on this channel. For the rest of you, I'm going to be doing all of this in my personal developer instance, or PDI for short. If you don't have one, go to developer.servicenow.com, register, and request one. And when you have done that, you'll see this Start Building button. Go ahead and jump into your instance. It's free, and you'll be able to practice along with me on your own instance of ServiceNow. Before we jump in, though, as of the making of this video, one caveat about using ES2021 in ServiceNow is that it is only available in scoped applications. So make sure you're not in the global scope. If you have an existing scope that was built in ES5, you can change it to 2021 by going to its app page, which you can do by clicking up here and then clicking on application scope and then clicking on this open record button once you have selected your scope. And then go down here to JavaScript mode and verify that it has been changed to ECMAScript 2021 or ES12. That's how you know you're in the new engine. If you don't have a custom app set up yet, aka your own custom scope, all you have to do is go to the application list, which you can do by clicking up here and then going to the open list button. And then say new, and then click start from scratch, and then follow those instructions and you'll be good to go. For the lessons in this video series, you will see me sometimes building code in a separate editor, like my Visual Studio Code editor. But for the most part, I will be testing and running all of our scripts inside ServiceNow under the background scripts module. To find background scripts, go to all, and then type in scripts, space, and you'll see scripts background. I usually like to favorite it so I can get to it quickly, but we'll be running most of our scripts within this screen so that we could see logging statements right away and generally test all of our code. Just make sure to change your scope to the one you created whenever you run your script. Finally, all the scripts and exercises you will see can be found at devlink.sn/sn-js. so that you can follow along at home. All the scripts for this series, Let's Learn ECMAScript, can be found in section 3. Whew. Okay, that was a very long intro video, but hopefully you learned along the way. I sincerely thank you again for joining me on this journey. If it behooves you, like and or comment on videos along the way, or don't, whatever. These videos aren't monetized anyways, so do what you want. Anyways, let's jump into all the new syntax.